I wanted to just direct, and that was the time when that direction ka keeda entered my head.
Oh my god, and we didn't know this. I mean, I didn't know that you wanted to be a director all this while.
Oh yes, all this while. The shooting was very funny because it was a one-day shoot of me rolling down the staircase. So they had actually constructed a sponge staircase for me to fall comfortably on. And after so many years also, I still see people coming up to me and talking about it. So
it must be funny also, right?
It was because it was so comfortable. I, as a director, I feel that a lot of work has to be done before you go on the set. She's a live wire and she's got a wicked sense of humor. And I mean, she keeps the whole set so happy.
For your time, it's a pleasure to have you on India Podcast for listeners, viewers, and more than that, it's a delight to see you because my memory with you will always first resonate with Hum Aapke Hai Kaun. I mean, I don't think anyone of any generation who have seen movies in India will not less relate to it.
Thank you so much.
I want to begin with this. I want to ask you. We all have seen you in different roles. Now, I actually was shocked to be honest, to know that, okay, you're directing a movie also, you're writing also. It was a surprise to me, I'll be very honest. And I'm very privileged that I got an opportunity to watch the great creation that you made.
Thank you.
I want to know from you, from your journey that we see, it's quite versatile. It's from playing... I don't know if I can say anchoring as a TV host or a talk show. We can say
sure.
That.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, and then, being that TV name, someone, a household name, to an artist, to an actor, to everything. And now that we know you're writing, you're directing, how do you look at yourself today when you turn around? Like, how do you want to define yourself?
You know, I'll tell you that it has been a very surprising journey for me because I'm pretty unambitious. So, as a kid, I never had these dreams of being an actor. Like some people really have it very early in life.
Yes.
And certainly. I really didn't know what I was going to do. As a child, I was just going with the flow. If anybody asked me at that time what your ambition is, all I wanted to do was have babies.
Oh my God.
even at that time.
That's so much a common Indian girl dream. You know, like
absolutely,
a young girl
I wanted babies.
Sari. Really?
Absolutely, really. And so, when I, and I was very good at academics. So, it just so happened that I kind of found my subject that I really was interested in my first year in college itself.
So that was psychology, right?
Psychology, yeah. And I then went on to do my master's in clinical psychology. And, this theater nasha was introduced to me in my college in the second year when we were performing this play called Andher Nagri Chopat Raja.
Wow, sounds interesting.
And and it had 14 songs. And I was actually part of the Sangeet Mandal. And then I was drawn into this because there was a lot of vocals that they required.
It was a musical play.
It was a musical. And I was fascinated with this whole process of, these guys who were with scripts one day and then without. And then they became their characters. And that journey was incredible. And Satyadev Dubey happened to be a family friend and he used to come over pretty often. Okay. And he asked me, he used to always ask me, even as a kid, ki theater karegi? And I used to say, nahi, nahi, mujhe koi interest nahi hai. And when he asked me this time round, I said, yes, karna hai mujhe. And that's how I stepped on the stage for the first time in his production. And I did workshops with him. And that was my introduction to
the acting world.
Yeah, and once I got into it, I mean, it just drew me in, and I did a lot of plays, experimental plays, especially in Marathi. And at that point in time, the television industry was in a very, very nascent stage. It had just begun.
And I think it was a big deal to be a TV personality. Like,
So at that time, people who were connected to theatre only were doing television serials.
Okay.
So my first break also came through people who were connected to Dubeji's theatre group. And Gulan and Jayant Kriplani did the serial called PC or Mossy.
Oh, yes.
And
yes.
Once that journey started, then, you know, I after circus, Aziz Mirza mentored me and told me that you have it in you to become a professional actress. I wanted to actually go back to doing my PhD because I was academically inclined.
But so there was a confusion in your mind.
I said, why not give it a try? Karke dekhte hain for some time. You know, I can always do my PhD later. Yes. And the next thing that was offered to me was Surabhi.
Oh, wow.
Surabhi, like, you know, none of us thought it would make history. But
that, yes, it just became our every house name. Yeah. Even circus, I think, did make but circus also did well.
Circus did well. All the things actually that I've done on television have really worked. And, you know, so that became my identity. Then Hum Aapke Hain Kaun happened. That became my identity. So slowly and steadily, I just kind of went with the flow. Completely went with the flow.
But did you...
Yes. In 1988, when I was doing the serial called Lifeline, Jeevan Rekha for Doordarshan, I had actually assisted Dr. Vijaya Mehta on that project. I was the fourth assistant, the costume assistant. Wow. And I was fascinated with filmmaking. Oh my God. I was just, I wanted to just direct. And that was the time when that direction ka keeda entered my head.
Oh my God. And we didn't know this. I mean, I didn't know that you wanted to be a director all this while.
Oh yes. All this while. And acting just happened, like I told you. And then when I had, you know, when I got married and I had children and I had taken a sabbatical from acting at that time.
Yes.
My husband reminded me of my passion for direction and said, this is the time, you know. And at that time, it was just the beginning of the golden phase of Marathi films.
Yes.
So I decided to adapt my mother's novel, Rita Vilinkar.
Rita, yes, of course.
Script.
Yes.
And so that's when in 2008, we started shooting Rita. But that was an adapted screenplay.
Yes, of
Then
course.
I started working on my original ideas for the screenplay. And, you know, all through life, I've always felt that, mera prashikshan kuch nahi hua. I don't have any formal training, neither in acting, nor in direction in that sense. So, I felt that wo khalti thi baat mujhe. So, what I did was, when I had this original idea for Tribhanga, I decided to apply for the Sundance Mumbai Mantra Screenwriters Workshop.
Okay. And so, you have done that formal training to come up.
And luckily for me, I got selected for that. It was just a week, the workshop, but it is an intense sort of workshop, and one is mentored, like I was mentored, Tribhanga was mentored by Bill Wheeler, Malia Scotch Marmo, Asif Kapadia, Anjum Rajabali, Joshua Marston, Marty Noxon, all these really, I mean, amazing screenwriters and directors even.
It's quite strange because you belong, certainly your lineage has that kind of a skill of writing, directing. Your mother is there.
Yeah.
So what is the kind of influence you saw of her on your, you know, there's a predominant influence. Like you're saying you wanted to be an academic child, but somewhere something kept pulling you.
Yeah.
So how do you define your mother's influence on your different aspect of this career? If I say, be it an actor or a director, writer, or exploring that space inconsistently, you know?
No, I mean, she's really been a huge support for me. And I would say even the matter of choosing something like this has come from the fact that she's exposed me to all the performing arts as a child. Yeah, they've always been part of it. So it was not just...
Only the Bollywood or only the...
Not at all. In fact, Bollywood was not part of our growing up years at all. We were not encouraged to watch commercial films at all. Like, I mean, we used to watch plays. We used to watch dance performances, classical Hindustani vocal recitals. Even Carnatic vocal recital. So I was exposed to, you know, the classical arts, Indian arts, very early in life, and reading, of course, a lot of reading. So all these things, architecture as a form, sculpture, all these things were part of the exposure that my mother gave me. So, you know, it makes its mark in a big way to the kind of person you develop into.
Exactly. Yes.
And for being a writer, especially, and also a director with a vision. What is vision? Yes. The fact that you have a sort of a different way of looking at things.
Yes.
Now, if you've looked at a lot of things and if you've been exposed to a lot of things, then that definitely adds to
it broadens your horizon. Experience. Yes.
Exactly. So I think that that is the main thing. And of course, she being a writer for me, she's like, you know, my sounding board. Like whatever yes. I write, she and my husband are two people I narrate the first kaccha drafts to.
The raw script.
Yeah. So their feedback for me means a lot. And my mother...
Was that the reason that you started your debut, you had your debut in direction with her script, with her book? Was it... Consciously taken.
Not only because that thing had that book now had stayed with me for a very long time. Like it was written in 1993, and I still felt that it was relevant in the day that I made it. So also because I could experiment with my mother's book, I could ask her for permission, and she would give it to me. So that was the convenience aspect of it was also there. But basically, because that stayed with me, it was something that I wanted to do, you know, I wanted to write. So once she approved of the screenplay, that is when I could say that, okay, fine, I'm ready to take it out to the world. If she hadn't approved of it, my writing career would have ended there and then.
But I want to come to this thing that you said you have been more exposed to the real art form, and then you did the big blockbuster. I mean, that time, I need to understand this, that playing a role as an artist, I think you're one of the rare artists who marked her presence, not being the lead, and yet everybody resonating with the character, and that being a commercial film. So how was that experience? What worked for you in that movie? And did you know it'll come through, like a big Pooja character will become a household name again?
I mean, when we were working, we knew that the film would work because it was working for all of us on the set. Okay. You know, you understand as performers, whether these things are working or not, you know, in terms of when you perform it. And what the reaction is, like we very often had a lot of actors on the set who were like, you know, not in speaking parts, but the crowds. We had a lot of crowds, like whether it was the marriage or whether it was, you know, the vidai or whether it was the...
It was a grand movie. It was like that.
Yeah, it was like, lots of people on the set.
Yes.
And everybody was enjoying themselves, you know, and everybody was kind of... absorbing what was going on and reacting that way. Like, I mean, Suraj didn't even have to tell them how to react in certain scenes. And
it was quite improvised.
Exactly. So I think that that is when you realize that this film is definitely going to make a mark in people's hearts. That it would run so much and that it would have such an iconic status in people's minds, we definitely wouldn't have been able to predict. And definitely not for myself and not for Pooja. I didn't expect her to be liked and loved so much. And after so many years also, I still see people coming up to me and talking about it. So, and I think that also makes people, you know, kind of, that character stay with people because it had such a tragic end, you know, in the film. In a very happy film, that was the only really sad thing that happens. You know.
But so in reality, how did it work out? Like when you guys were recording it, how was the mahol? Can you just share that vivid memories of how would it happen? You had a toughie on the set also all the time. So.
Yeah, but while I was rolling down, there was nobody because I was alone. You know, obviously it was a sequence where nobody else was around at that time. When I fall from the staircase, Salman and Madhuri are supposedly in the room.
Yes.
So they don't know what is happening. And so the shooting was very funny because it was a one-day shoot of me rolling down the staircase, and it was very funny also because Rajshri Productions really respects and loves their actors so much that they wouldn't want to put us ill at ease at any point in time. So they had actually constructed a sponge staircase for me to fall comfortably on.
We nobody would know that, really. You're the first one.
I didn't feel it. I didn't feel the pain, so I had to act it.
My God, that was really tough. I mean, how can one create a sponge set to... It must be funny also, right?
It was because it was so comfortable.
And how many takes were you taking for that? Did it happen like
there were a lot of takes because there was this rolling down from the whole staircase, and then there were bits and parts in different magnifications.
Yes.
And the end of it where, you know, I'm hurt and I roll down, just the last bit where I get hurt. It was a whole day's work, definitely. But it was fine. We had an action master also on the set to see to it that nothing untoward happened. But I must tell you that the experience of the place where I pass away in the hospital.
Yes.
That has stayed with me because Reema ji was very affected by that. I mean, she couldn't come out of the scene though the scene was over. Because I think it is so difficult for any mother to go through the emotions of losing a child. I think she just couldn't, as a mother and as an actress, get over that fact that this child is no more. And she couldn't stop crying. I mean, I had to kind of hold her and say that, listen, look at me, I'm here, I'm alive, you know, that kind of thing.
No.
For her to feel okay, it's, you know, to come
she
out of it, she required a lot of time,
You know, because
it
now
it's difficult to accept her.
Did you also have certain of those, any of those memories that you hold on with even today?
Like of crying?
Emotionally, emotionally or something that stays with you with that particular making.
Of Hamapke Hikon, I think, you know, it was so much fun for me to do throughout. And it was 150 days of work. And at the end of it, we were not going to see anybody. And when each and every artist was, you know, their role was over and they were, you know, not needed after that.
So it was a favorite.
Dachri Productions used to, you know, kind of put the, play this song, Tumse Juda Hokar Mujhe Door
Jana Hai.
Oh my
God, it's such a...
And all of us, you know, I mean, we were like, in tears. I think our set was flooded with tears because
oh my God,
just so
I don't know, people get so sensitive on sets with every emotion. That's so sweet. Coming to something that we see now, Tribhang, it's a very intense story, if we can relate it to like that, because there's so much emotion in, and more script driven, more story driven, and you have very much you know, focused on some characters. So the story, I don't know, I felt it was a mix of a theater approach. It was a not so commercial. Can you tell us, how did this come to your life, this whole Tribhang chapter, how it opened for you? And what made you go for this?
Well, I was, as I said, I wanted to give a script for Sundance Mumbai Mantra Workshop. And they had asked for a 10-page script, just with some characters and some little scenes. So I had written out a few scenes, and of course, Nayan, Anu and Masha were definitely there in the script. Mm. Robindro was there, Baba was there, you know, these characters were there, Aji was there. So it was a 10-pager basically, where I had a basic idea of how the graph of the entire script would be, but it was nowhere close to being a script as such. So
it was just a thought or a...
It was, it was something that I was thinking of in terms of unconventional women with unconventional choices facing, even in the urban setting, many people, you know, when they think of patriarchy affecting women, it's usually rural women that you think of.
Yes.
But it has a very, you know, it's there, prevalent, even in urban areas, even in very, very, you know, proficient women, educated women.
Yes.
And it goes through all sorts of family structures. And, you know, the kind of flack that women face for their choices, which are actually so personal that nobody else has to have any, you know, kind of opinion about them. So I was toying with all these ideas, you know, basically. And since I'm a psychology student, I had fit those characters into id, ego and superego. You know, that was...
Okay.
So Anu's character is id. Nan's is ego and Masha's is super ego.
I didn't look at it like that. Now that you're saying,
I mean, that was the construct of the basic characterizations. And then, of course, later I worked on the thing and then got the whole graph. Those were the themes, and there were certain themes that I was, you know, kind of wanting to deal with regarding women characters.
Yes.
So, writing characters for writing women characters not of just a young age, writing them not in romantic roles,
yes,
writing them in things that we observe all around us but are not particularly shown on screen very often, you know. So writing women characters not in relation to other men, like I mean kisi ki biwi kisi ki behan nahi, this is my hero and the other people are, you know, around them, whether men or women, they are on the periphery, but my heroes are my women, you know.
Two questions I have. One, as a director, when you're making a movie of this kind, Tribhang directing, what are the things that you learned or you think you one should be keeping in mind? Because what are your learnings from the making of this particular story?
No, you know, as a director, I have always been a very sort of hands-on director. Like, I'm one of those directors who will be in the edit, who will be in the grading, who will be in the...
You're doing everything.
Like a homemaker. It's like my baby. Yeah, so, you know, I mean, and it's a collaborative effort and I really respect the entire cast and crew. I'm extremely respectful and grateful to them for their, you know, coming together for this collaboration. But I, as a director, I feel that a lot of work has to be done before you go on the sets.
Okay.
Because that kind of, you know, to bring everybody on the same page, to not have any extra discussions on the set, because I don't like wasting anybody's time or money.
You're a strict director.
I'm not a strict director. I'm very disciplined. I would like to say.
Disciplined.
I'm a disciplined director. So, and yet to be flexible enough to allow space for any emergencies or any magic also that people come up with, like actors come up with, technicians
improvise,
come up with.
Yes.
Yeah, improvise the scene. So it's that kind of balance that I like to achieve on the set. But I definitely don't like wasting my producer's money. I'm not self-indulgent as a director because I'm not self-indulgent as a person. So maybe that's, you know, personality.
That's your personality.
Translates onto how you work. But I feel in terms of Tribhanga, the script itself determined for me how I should direct it, because ultimately it's an autobiography. I mean, that's why it is short in terms of that as if my characters are actually speaking in the first person to
very uniquely the done. Yes, totally.
Yeah. So that is what I mean. If in any other narrative, you're not going to see people nearly nearly talking very close to the camera. At most times. So even apart from the interviews, I've maintained that style because finally we are seeing the story of these three women culminating into the autobiography, which is Tribhanga.
Yes,
so that's how I saw it as a director and that's how I visualized it.
Did it have a personal life anecdote quite attached to the whole story? Because
definitely. Ek toh, the background is the same. I come from a Maharashtrian background. I have seen a lot of people from the field of literature, arts. So that's something that I'm very, very familiar with. Even when I was doing theatre, I'm familiar with the kind of people that, you know, exist, how they come home, how they talk, how they, you know, in the 80s, of course. And then being an 90s sort of in the space of Bollywood, in the space of this, that is also something of my observation. And you know, and even today's world, which I've shown Masha's family, I have observed, like, I mean, you know, I've seen so many families like that even in today's times. So whatever you do, it comes out of your own experience. It might not be autobiographical, but it comes out of the experience of what you've lived and what you've seen or what you've imagined also.
Totally.
And that imagination is also based somewhere on your own experiences or something that you've read, something some person you've met, you know, that kind of thing. So this hatred thing actually is something that one girl just casually mentioned to me when she got married. Now, when I was doing Surabhi, she met me. She was an acquaintance of mine.
Okay.
And she said that, you know, I'm so glad that I'm married. Now I can escape my mother who I hate. Mm. And for me,
it was a big thing, like a big emotion.
Shocking. because I had such a beautiful, I still have such a beautiful yes. relationship with my mother, my grandmother, my Masi. I was surrounded with really strong women, you know, but it was such a beautiful relationship. And I felt that, my God, these women are my core. My mother is my core. And suppose I had actually grown up hating her, what would happen to me? Would I be as grounded as I am? Would I be, you know, as, you know, malleable maybe as I am, adjusting as I am? Or would I be like Anu? So that's how Anu was born, you know, as a rebel.
So how was it working with Kajol on particularly with this character? Was it fun? Because she's she's all...
Oh my God, she's a live wire and she's got a wicked sense of humor. And I mean, she keeps the whole set alive. So happy. I think, and that really suits me because I like happy people. I like working with happy people. Even if you're making an intense film or if you're doing a serious scene, that does not mean that you have to be serious off screen.
Totally. You know? But with the character, the personality Kajol has and the character you wrote for her, wasn't it quite opposite? Was it like she brought a different look to the character? Because she's so opposite it. She's not the one who will be so worried in life or have any such strong...
I mean, I think that she is completely different from Anu in the sense that, as a person, she is not Anu at all. But she definitely understands her completely and she knows the motivation for Anu. And that is, I think, a very key factor when you have to portray something realistically.
Yes.
And, unless she had, kind of felt that Anu is born out of these problems and she felt convinced with it, she wouldn't have been able to be this natural as
totally.
Anu. She herself is a very natural, spontaneous actor.
Yes.
She's very intuitive. Yeah. So she does not really, she's not part of that method working. That's not part of
No, that's not her thing. Okay.
So she's very instinctive and she used to get things from, which I hadn't even thought of sometimes in Anu's characters, the way she would say it or the way she would, kind of say certain things. So she's made it completely her own.
Wow.
And it was so, it flew, so beautifully. There was a fluidity.
It fit your imagination the way you wanted to make. Rinko, we have so many people, when I put this out that we are getting you on the show, so many people wanted to talk to you. We just couldn't manage to take all, but we took a few of them. So I have from Mumbai, Komal Jain joining us. You have followers, I don't know, across generations now. So I don't need, it was so nice to see that. So I would like to call on Komal Jain on screen. She wants to take a question with you. She is an event
Hi.
Hi, Komal.
Renuka, I'm a die-hard fan of yours.
Thank you.
Work since hum aapke hain kaun, and you just mind-blowing.
Thank you so much.
From hum aapke hain gone to Ribanka has been spectacular. You know, as a mother, as a woman, as a director. So whom do you contribute your success to?
I would contribute it to maybe the kind of values that I have got from my parents, definitely, because I mean, I just lucked out where my parents were concerned. It's just a chance thing, what kind of parents you get. You have no choice in the matter. So that's the first privilege that I have been born with, I think. And so everything else followed. I would say that, the support of a lot of people while growing up, my teachers, people I've learned from, my co-actors, now at home, my husband, my house helps, my children, and everybody, who I have learned from, I would attribute my success to. And of course, the audience, my goodness. I mean, I had never imagined the kind of love that I would get in various stages of my life. And it continues today. And I'm overwhelmed by that feeling of being blessed, So... I attribute it to my parents, but definitely they are the ones who I would like to thank for everything that I do, in a way.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Komal, for that question. This one question came back in again, that when do we see you direct Madhuri, or you and Madhuri together? What is your answer? I don't know why, but people are quite looking for that.
No. In fact, I am looking forward to it. Yes. I have told Madhuri this also very often, and I'm sure when the right script comes, which I will write definitely. Then I will definitely approach her, because she's such a dear friend and she's such a beautiful co-star. I also feel where she's concerned that her entire talent has not been explored as yet.
Okay, wow.
There are lots of aspects of Madhuri Dixit as an actor that are still waiting to be explored. So definitely I will definitely direct.
Yes. While we wrap up, we have this fun segment. So my team prepares this fun game with you very quick, like a rapid fire.
Okay.
So my team member Chetna can join in, and we just are going to ask you some fun, quick questions.
Sure.
As well as quick you want to answer. So let's begin with this and that, the first game that we have.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, Chetna.
How are you?
Okay. I'm good. A bit nervous.
But I'm so excited also. Okay, so this is very easy. I'm going to give you two options and you have to pick one, okay?
Oh God, okay.
So now that I'm seeing so many books behind you, so what is the idea of your fun weekend? Reading books or just being lazy in front of TV?
Right now, not books. Definitely on OTT with a lovely hot cup of coffee in my hand. That's like chilling life.
Okay. Being an actor or a director?
Director, hands down.
Wow.
Hum aapke hai kaun or Rita? Rita.
Sorry.
That's hum aapke hai kaun.
Being a more loved mother or playing the part of a wife?
Loved mother.
That's so okay. So we have one more game. There is one word for these names. You just need to tell us what comes in your head when you listen to these names. We have Madhuri Dixit.
Beautiful.
Wow. Kajol Devgan.
Gorgeous.
Ashutosh Rana.
Love.
Wow. And Manish Vail, because he was playing that role.
Gentleman.
Wow, that's so sweet. And that's quite an end of our entire segment. But we are a little playful with our segment also. We have some funny memes out there. You know, so many memes.
Oh, my memes.
Yes, your memes. So just your reaction to them.
Okay, so we're going to go.
Yeah.
Okay.
I can't read.
Okay, removes cover from a phone for a
phone.
Day.
I've shared this.
Oh my God.
Okay, it's so true. It is so true. The moment you do that, your phone's gone.
Oh God. That's so funny. And I didn't see this. I'm seeing it for the first time.
Okay, no, I shared
so
this on my Insta.
I close as soon as I... Okay, that,
open
that
my
is, the so clothes falling is, off your cupboard when you open that.
Oh, door. Yes. Oh, my God. Especially for teenagers, I would say definitely.
That you can say for your children then.
Yeah.
So the next one is... Oh, no, nobody. Parle Ji biscuit and chai.
Wow.
Oh God, and then you have to search for it now that it goes all mushy and
but it's so sporting of you to take these head on and find it so funny.
But so, yeah, so creative, yeah.
You've seen it all. I think you've got all of them.
And I think the last one,
they tag me now in it, so
and I think the last one is most relatable, and I think everybody would agree. So, this is what I feel whenever I watch Hum Aapke Hai Kaun. I can never continue.
That is so sweet. That is
I cannot continue beyond this song.
Oh, that's really lovely.
So that was really nice interacting and knowing so many aspects of you, because we have actually not known you in this many aspects. And today you've so much candidly spoken about different roles. And especially, I didn't know you started with this whole thought of being a director. And Tribhang was a fabulous, fabulous script movie.
Thank you.
I don't know how it happened to you, but it was one of the best. Thanks.
Thank you.
It was such a pleasure. I would thank you again for being part of this discussion, taking it so sportingly and allowing us to put through the questions. I would like everyone to come on screen who's there, Ashish and all the team who are sitting there.
Yeah. I'd like to thank all of them.
All of them wanted to meet you. More than that, they were like, are you serious? We're getting her. I'm like, yes, we can. Thank you all so much.
Thank you for your time, ma'am.
It was a pleasure. Hope to see Madhuri and you together in your next
Yay. Thank you.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure. Thank you, Prateek, for organizing this for us. It was a real pleasure.
Thank you so much, Anku. Thank you, Renuka ji.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you guys.
Bye.